So let us now begin with the case study discussion. We would be discussing about a case study regarding a small village. The case circulates around Amanda. Amanda has come to Hansrajpur village, a small village lying on the outskirts of Agra in Uttar Pradesh. She worked as a project management associate as a part of global beverage company. So let us take some few points about it. Like, they have set up their manufacturing and bottling plant in the region. She always paid a visit to monitor the company's plant and their operations. It was one of the most efficient and cost-effective plant for Mark, the beverage company for which she was working for. Over the time, she has made a good rapport with against the villagers and was over time invited by many in the village to be hosted for. And Shambhu, the ward member of the region, was quite fond of him, and she had stayed at her place. The villager used to call her as Ami Devi, Amidi, Amidi. And this year, she, however, when came to stay at Shambhu for her yearly assessment, she was welcomed by Shambhu's wife, but Shambhu avoided meeting with her. And she also noticed that the villagers were also avoiding and not that interactive what they were earlier. So she tried to have a communication with Shambhu. Shambhu kept on avoiding him, like he didn't show up for dinner and all. Next day, she waited Shambhu to have a breakfast together, but Shambhu again avoided her. So then she finally approached Shambhu's wife, Nirmala, and tried to find out the reason. Then what Nirmala did is, Nirmala took Amanda to the stream, or the you can say the river bank, where what Amanda noticed there was the stream has narrowed down and the water level has also lowered. The stream was considered to be the village's lifeline, and over 8 months it has slowly gone depleting. Lowering magnitude of rain over this year last season also didn't help the cause much, as the water body did not get fed by its natural source of replenishment. This, apart from the fact that the underground wastewater treatment switch pipe of the plant had broken, and even after multiple requests to the plant manager, it is not being mended. He has not attended the requested and is making no attempts to mend the broken wastewater disposal of the plant. Now, this not only has led to the shortage of drinking and bathing water, but has also reduced the irrigation usage of the water. Thus, it has led the villagers on the slow trodden path of being feminized. Nirmala also told her that villagers had protested against this gross mismanagement, but still there was nothing from the plant administration. Feeling helpless and no clue about what to do, they waited for Amanda to appear. Now, Amanda, listening to this, she was horrified at the plight of the villagers and decided to take up this matter in haste to the company administration. Firstly, and almost instantly, she went to the plant and ordered a halt of operations. So what we observe is, Amanda was very quick in acting. This is a very good sign for a manager. The moment she heard the problems and all, she immediately acted upon. What she did was, she also observed the behavioral changes. You need to understand this. If you are going for any project proposals and you are observing any kind of behavioral changes in the locals, then you need to ask questions. You need to find why these behavioral changes are happening, because in longer run this would create disparity among the locals and the project. And obviously, the locals are your stakeholders, so disparity among your project and your stakeholders is not a good sign. So let us now come back to our case study. Then what Amanda did is she immediately headed back to the country head office in Bangalore and went to meet Mr. Anand Jha, the country head and operations. Then Mr. Jha, upon listening from Amanda about the incident, he was quite shocked that under his nose, how come these kind of activities are happening and he had no information about. He immediately established a company under his direct supervision and flung to action almost immediately. A small team of experts were immediately sent to the area and they were asked to carry out ground reporting as well as to carry out immediate repair of the sewage treatment unit. Based on the ground report presented in a time span of 15 days, the stream water cleaning activity along with the village community was taken up. It took another 1 month for the cleanup to come up with fruitful results. The company then brought up some of its engineers to build a water harvesting system. This is quite good. They come up with an alternative solution for it. So a separate water war fund from the company profits was set up to look after its establishment over time. A committee was formed with some members of the organization and the members from the village as well. So you are involving as you are taking some members from the villages, matlab means you are involving the stakeholders in the project. It would give a sense of ownership, like you are involved in the project, it's a part of you, it's a part of your community, in that format. So a monitoring committee was set up within an organization whose responsibility was to be in touch with the village level committee. This committee was under the direct supervision of Amanda and Mr. Jha. They decided to take up such initiatives at 23 such locations across the country to mark their approach of giving it back to the society in ways more than one. And this is how Amanda turned around the dying hope of a village. So this was a quite interesting case study regarding sustainability. So we need to make sure that our project and the environment are at equal level. We won't go for a project which would be, on other hand, would be damaging our environment. So we need to take into consideration that. So I hope all the concepts we discussed in our sessions are loud and clear. Now I would be giving you an overall summary of the discussion. The chapter focuses on the entire way of funding the project and putting the funding proposal in the project proposal as well as the stakeholders' intended financial benefit out of each investment. We started off with the reasons as to why would a project require financing, or the scenarios in which we can approach for financing. We then looked for various financial instruments, the merits and the demerits of the project financing methodologies. We then took over the ways to assess the decision of a financing a project and the capital structuring model. We looked at multiple mathematical models of capital structuring, simultaneously looking at the determinants of capital structuring. Financial models were pondered upon, looking for the ways to optimize and process the return on investments. Moving on from financial investment and the financial impact, we looked at the ways of sustainability. Sustainability can be brought in as a parameter for calculating return on investment. The ways in which we as investors can generate a sustainable return on investment, and looked at dimensions such as why is sustainability in investments important in the current day and age, and how can we attach a tangible value to the sustainable return generated on investment, and ending the chapter on a case study as to ponder how a conventional company approached sustainability in its operation. began with discussing about finance, how and why and its importance. Then we went on to discuss about its methodology, and then we went on to discuss about sustainability, like return on sustainability, return on investment on the basis of sustainability. So this was our overall discussion. Hope you liked it, and thank you for your patience, and that would be it for our discussions. Thank you.